ओम शांति। 1 सितंबर 2021 इंग्लिश मुरली। इसेंस स्वीट चिल्ड्रन द फादर द लॉर्ड ऑफ लाइफ हु सेव्स योर लाइव्स हैज कम टू प्ले द स्वीट मुरली ऑफ नॉलेज टू यू चिल्ड्रन टू सेव योर लाइव्स। क्वेश्चन विच फेथ डू ओनली द फॉर्चुनेट चिल्ड्रन हैव। आंसर द फेथ दैट द फादर हु मेक्स आवर फॉर्चून एलिवेटेड has come. We are receiving from the Father the fruit of our devotion. The Father has now come to take us back home with Him by restoring to us the wings that Maya cut off. Only fortunate children have this faith. Today's song, Who has come in the early morning hours? Om Shanti. Who comes and plays the murli early in the morning? The world is in total darkness. You are now listening to the murli from the Father, the ocean of knowledge, the purifier, the Lord of life. He is God, the one who saves your life. People say, "Oh God, release me from this suffering." Those people ask for limited help. You children are now receiving unlimited help because He is the unlimited Father. You know that souls are incognito and that the Father is also incognito. The bodies of the children are visible and the Father's body is also visible. Souls are incognito and so their Father is also incognito. You know that the Father has come to give you the unlimited inheritance. The Srimad, that is elevated directions, are from Him. The Gita, the jewel of all scriptures, is very well known. They have just changed the name in it. You now know that Srimad are the versions spoken by God. You have also understood that it is the one Father who makes those who are corrupt into elevated beings. He is the one who changes ordinary human beings into Narayan. There is the story of the true Narayan. It is said the story of immortality is to make you into the masters of the land of immortality. It is to change humans into Narayan. It is the same thing. This is the land of death. No one knows Bharat was the land of immortality. Here too, immortal Baba has told everything to you people of Bharat. There wasn't just one Parvati and one Draupadi. There are many children who are listening to this. Shri Baba is speaking to you through Brahma. The Father says, I am explaining to you sweetest spirits through Brahma. The Father has explained to you children that you definitely have to become soul conscious. Only the Father can make you this. Not a single human being in the world has knowledge of the soul. If they don't have knowledge of souls, how could they have knowledge of the Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul? They say each soul is the Supreme Soul. The whole world is trapped in such a big mistake. At this time, the intellects of people are of no use at all. They are making preparations for their own destruction. This is nothing new for you children. You know that according to the drama, those are their parts. They are bound by the bounds of the drama. Nowadays, there is a lot of upheaval in the world. You children have loving intellects at the time of destruction. It is said that those whose intellects have no love for the Father are led to destruction. This world now has to change. You know that the Mahabharata war also took place previously and that the Father taught you Raj Yoga. In the scriptures, they have spoken about total destruction of the whole world. However, total destruction cannot take place. Otherwise, there would be total annihilation. No humans or anything else other than the five elements would remain. That would be impossible. If annihilation were to take place, where would human beings come from? They show that Krishna came on a betel leaf floating in the ocean. How could a baby come like that? They have written such things in the scriptures don't even ask. Arrows of knowledge now have to be shot at scholars such as Bhisham Pitama by Yukumaris. In the future, they too will come here. The more powerful you become in doing service and the more you continue to give the father's introduction, the more impact there will be. Yes, there will also be obstacles. It is also remembered that many obstacles were created in this sacrificial fire by the devilish community. You won't be able to teach them. Only the father teaches knowledge and yoga. Only the one father is the bestower of salvation. Only he purifies the impure. Therefore, he would surely give knowledge to only those who are impure. Can the father ever be omnipresent like they say? You children understand that we become lords of divinity by having divine intellects. Look how many temples human beings have built. However, they don't understand who they were or what they did when they existed. There is also a temple to the Lord of Divinity. Bharat was the land of divinity. There were palaces studded with diamonds and jewels. It was just a matter of yesterday. They say that the golden age alone was hundreds of thousands of years old, whereas the father says the whole drama is 5,000 years. That is why it is said, look at what Bharat is today and what it was yesterday. No one could remember anything that was hundreds of thousands of years ago. You children have now remembered everything. You know it is a matter of 5,000 years. Baba says, sit in yoga. Consider yourselves to be souls and remember the Father. This is knowledge, is it not? They are hatha yogis. Each one sits with one leg over the other. Look at what they do. You mothers cannot do that. You cannot sit like they do. There are so many images on the path of devotion. The father says, sweet children, there is no need for you to do anything like that. Students in a school sit in a disciplined way. The father doesn't even tell you to do that much. You can sit as you please. If you become tired of sitting down, then just lie down. Baba doesn't forbid you to do anything. These matters are very easy to understand. There is no difficulty in this. Even if you are ill, you could leave your body while listening to this and staying in remembrance of Shri Baba. It is said that the water of the Ganges should be on your lips and you should be on the banks of the Ganges when you shed your body. All of those things belong to the path of devotion. In fact, it means the nectar of knowledge. You know, the soul truly is going to leave the body in this way. When you children come down here, you leave me behind. The father says, I will take you children back with me. I have only come to take you children back home. You souls neither know your home nor yourselves. Maya has completely cut off your wings. It is because souls are tamopradhan that they are unable to fly. How can they return to the land of peace unless they become satopradhan? You also know that according to the drama plan, everyone has to become tamopradhan. At this time, the whole tree has reached a state of total decay. No one here can have a satopradhan stage. When a soul becomes pure here, he can no longer remain here. He would depart from here. Everyone performs devotion in order to receive liberation. However, no one can return home yet. The law doesn't allow this. The father sits here and explains all of these secrets for you to imbibe. Nevertheless, the main thing is to remember the father and become a spinner of the discs of self-realization. When you remember the seed, your intellects become aware of the whole tree. You come to know everything in a second. No one in the world knows that only the one father is the seed of the whole human world. Krishna is not God. Krishna is called the ugly and beautiful one, that is Shyam Sundar. It isn't that he became dark blue because he was bitten by a poisonous snake. It is by sitting on the pyre of lust that human beings become ugly. They even show Rama as dark blue, who bit him. They don't understand anything. However, those who have this in their fortune and have faith in it will definitely claim the inheritance from the Father. If they don't have faith, they will never be able to understand. If they don't have this in their fortune, what effort would they make? When they don't have this in their fortune, they sit as though they don't understand anything. They don't even have the faith that the Father has come to give them this unlimited inheritance. Just as a new student who goes and sits in a medical college doesn't understand anything, so some come and sit here in the same way. This imperishable knowledge is never destroyed. What could they come and do? When a kingdom is being established, maids, servants, subjects, and servants of the subjects are all needed. As you make further progress, they will try to study, but it will be difficult then because there will be a lot of upheaval at that time. Storms continue to increase day by day. There are so many centers. Therefore, some will come and understand very well. It is written that establishment takes place through Brahma. Destruction is just ahead. Destruction definitely has to take place. They say that fewer children should be born. However, the tree has to grow. While the Father is here, souls of all religions have to come down here. When it is time to return home, there will be no more souls to come down. Everyone now has to come down, but no one understands these matters. They say God is the protector of the devotees. Therefore, there must definitely have been calamities for the devotees. Everyone in Ravan's kingdom has become a completely sinful soul. At the end of the Iron Age, it is Ravan's kingdom, and at the beginning of the Golden Age, it is Rama's kingdom. At this time, everyone belongs to the devilish community of Ravan. They say so-and-so has become a resident of heaven, which means that this is hell. If he has become a resident of heaven, then that is good. Look what he would have been here. He would definitely have been a resident of hell. They don't even understand they are residents of hell. You now understand that only the Father comes and makes you into residents of heaven. He is remembered as Heavenly God the Father. Only He comes and establishes heaven. Everyone sings and remembers the purifier as Rama, who belongs to Sita. They sing, "We are impure and you are the one who can purify us." All of them are the Sitas who belong to the path of devotion, and the Father is Rama. When you tell people this directly, they don't believe it. They call out to Rama, "The Father has now given each of you children a third eye. It is as though you now belong to a different world." The Father explains, "Everyone definitely had to become Tamo Pradhan now, for only then could the Father come and make you Sato Pradhan." The Father explains everything so well. He says, "Even though you children do your own duties, just remember one thing. Remember the Father. No one else can show you the way to become Sato Pradhan. The spiritual surgeon of all is one. He is the one who comes and gives an injection to souls, because it is souls who have become Tamo Pradhan. The Father is called the eternal surgeon. Souls are imperishable, and the Father, the Supreme Soul, is also imperishable. From being Sato Pradhan, souls have now become Tamo Pradhan. Souls need an injection." The Father says, "Children, consider yourselves to be souls and remember your Father. Connect your intellects in yoga with up above and you will go to your sweet home. It is in your intellects that you now have to go to your sweet silence home. Achcha, to the sweetest beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bap Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children extend their love, remembrance, say good morning, namaste, and thank you to the spiritual Bap Dada. Essence for Dharana. First point. Make your intellect divine with knowledge and yoga. No matter how ill you are or how much difficulty there is, even in that situation, you must remember the Father. Number two. In order to make your fortune elevated, let your intellect have full faith. Connect your intellect in yoga to your sweet silence home. Blessing. May you become double light and make difficult tasks easy by constantly having the awareness of the combined form. Explanation. The children who constantly stay in remembrance constantly experience His company. When any problem comes in front of them, they experience themselves to be combined and do not become afraid. The awareness of the combined form will make any difficult task easy. When any big situation comes in front of you, hand over your burdens to the Father and become double light. Your mind will then continue to dance in happiness day and night like an angel's. Slogan. Those who find a solution to everything and remain content and make others content are jewels of contentment. Om Shanti. Invaluable versions of Mateshwari Ji. Topic is Contrast of Knowledge and Yoga. Explanation. Yoga and knowledge are two words. Remembrance of God is referred to as yoga. The word yoga is not used for the remembrance of anyone else. The yoga that gurus teach is also of connecting with God. But they do not have the full introduction to God and so they do not have much success in yoga. Yoga and knowledge are both powers, and by making effort in these two subjects, you receive might and you become a conqueror of sinful actions and make your life elevated. Everyone speaks of yoga, but you first of all need to have the introduction of the one you are having yoga with. We receive God's introduction from God, and by having yoga through that introduction, we have total success. With yoga, we burn our burden of past sins, and with knowledge, we realize what actions we have to perform in the future and why. The roots of our lives are our sanskars, and eternal souls are made of sanskars. But our sanskars continue to change through our actions. Souls become great through yoga and knowledge, and you also develop power in your lives, but both these things are received from God. It is from God that we find the way to become free from our karmic bondages. No one but God can give us power to become free from the karmic bondages of the sins we have committed so that our future actions are not sinful. God brings both yoga and knowledge. He inspires us to burn our sins in the fire of yoga, and He teaches us how to perform elevated actions in the future through which our actions become neutral. This is why God has said, the philosophy of action, neutral action and sinful action is very deep. Now we souls need direct power from God. We cannot receive the powers of yoga and knowledge from the scriptures. We can only receive this from the Almighty Authority, the All-Powerful One. We now have to make the roots of our lives, that is sanskars, such that we have happiness in our lives. So God comes and sows the seed of pure sanskars, and on the basis of these pure sanskars, we will become liberated in life for half the cycle. Acha, Om Shanti. की आश पावर ऑफ सकाश, जॉइन पावर ऑफ सकाश राइट नाउ। हमारा व्हाट्सएप नंबर है 8770659619। नंबर पुनः नोट कीजिए 8770659619। याद रहे यह नंबर केवल मैसेजेस के लिए है। यदि अभी तक आपने इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है तो पावर ऑफ सकाश मधुबन के इस चैनल को जल्दी से सब्सक्राइब कर लें और बेल आइकन को भी ज़रूर प्रेस करें, ताकि जो भी महारथियों के द्वारा वेबिनार्स, योग भट्टी या अन्य प्रोग्राम्स हो रहे हैं, आप उनका लाभ घर बैठे उठा सकें।